Hello guys, welcome to our own channel Chess Radio Kolkata. Now I'm going to show you a game that is played by Computer Hope against Mezo 40. So you can see the rating is 1966. So he might be considered as the 2000 rated player, and Computer Hope is only just 1500. So with one mistake, he easily defeated his 2000 rated player, and he's playing with the black pieces. So it's e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop c4. That is the Italian game, and if he played with the h6, that is the Italian game, anti-fried liver defense. Now I can show you that why h6 is so much important. Because without h6, if you are developing your knight, then knight to f6, then the knight can jump to the g5, and now if you are blocking, yeah, let me show you that this knight is attacking on the square, that is the f7, and this bishop is also attacking on the f7 square. So at this position you can see that this knight is come to the f7, and he can pop the rook and the queen. So it is very much important to play the d5 at this position, and after he captures d5, if you capture with the knight, then you are gone, because after knight captures f7 and king captures f7, you can definitely give a check from queen f3, and if white moves king g8, then game can be finished very fast. Like queen captures d5, queen captures d5, bishop captures d5, and after bishop e6, and just bishop captures e6, that is checkmate. So within 10 moves your opponent can be checkmated if you are not so much careful at this position and play any normal move like knight f6. So it's very much important to play a6. H6, and that is the anti-fried liver attack. Now c3, the Italian game, knight f6, d4, into d4, c into d4. But here I can recommend that e5 is the best move. Now if you push this knight, then it should be more fun. But although here after e captures d4, c captures d4, bishop b4 check, blocking with the knight c3, now bishop captures c3. Now here you can play knight into e4, because this knight is pinned. You can see guys, after knight captures e4, this knight is pinned, and you are gaining a tempo. But although after knight c3, just bishop captures c3, and after b captures c3, d6. This d6 is the blunder. Here also you can capture the knight into e4. Why people doesn't capture the central pawn, I didn't know. But although it is d6, now short castle. Queen c2, knight a5, bishop d3, bishop g4, knight d2, rook e8, h3, h5, bishop h5, that's a very good move, bishop h5, rook e1, bishop g6, yes, that is the reason, because before the two or three moves, like at this position, this bishop belongs to the c8 square. Now from c8 square maneuvering to the h7 or g6 is very much good. So I just show you that after rook e1 he plays bishop g6, now knight f3, but here you can play the c4. Yes, engine is also recommending the c4. You can see guys, you need to push your pawns, because you have the 1, 2 and 3 central pawns. So you need to push up your pawns. But here he play knight f3, b6. Here you can deal with the e5. Engine is recommending that, but b6 was okay. Now knight h4, bishop h7, e5. Now this pawn is attacking the f6 knight, and this bishop and queen are creating a battery on the h7 b2 diagonal, the light square diagonal. Now bishop into d3, queen into d3, d into e5, queen f5. There is a blunder, the queen f5. Now you can see e into d4. Now if white can capture the rook, then knight can capture, and that's a fair game for both of the guys. But here is the mistakes. After a blunder like queen f5, he is creating another blunder. After e into d4, he just captured c into d4. Now you can see the rook on e1 is hanging. So rook cross e1 check, king h2, queen d6 check, g3, queen into d4, rook b1, queen e4, queen into e4, knight into e4, knight f3, rook f1, knight h4, rook into f2 check, knight g2, and after rook into a2, bishop f4, c5, rook e1, knight d2. Now you can see simply he tried to protect the knight, but that is the mistake, because after knight f3 check, you need to move your king, and that is the checkmate. Or you can play it alternatively, like if you want to just at this position, after knight f3 check, you cannot block this, so you just need to play that king h1 and then rook captures e2. And that's the winning for black, because black has four pieces rather than two pieces. So it's an easy win. And now I can show you another thing, that is the Arabian mate. Now you people who are familiar with the Arabian mate, that is, if at this position white can play knight e3, then rook goes to h2. That is called the Arabian mate. Okay. So thanks for watching this game. I hope we will meet you soon. Till then, bye bye.